Check this out. When I search for how to smoke a brisket at home, I will see these keywords. This is the keyword we have searched for, and it has a monthly search volume of 40. How to smoke brisket at home, which has a search volume of 40 as well. And then how to smoke a brisket Kansas City style, which has a search volume of 10. What if I search for how to make smoked brisket at home? As you can see, the keyword has a monthly search volume of 10. Now let's put all the keywords we have together. Do they have similar meanings? The first three are, right? Do these keywords serve the same purpose when people are searching for them? Yes, people searching for these three keywords are looking for the same information about smoking brisket at home. They have the same search intent, but the last keyword is a little more specific and answers another search intent. And how do you verify that these three keywords belong to the same cluster? Simply go to Google and search for them. For the first keyword, remember this article that ranks at the top? Let's search for the next keyword. The previous article may not be in the same position for this keyword, but it ranks for it in the top 10. The same goes for the next keyword, as you can see right here. But if we search for the last keyword, the article we have seen earlier is nowhere to be found, as you can see. So, keyword cluster simply means a group of keywords that share the same search intent. So when you write an article that targets one keyword, it will rank for the other keywords as well. I hope my explanation is good enough. If it is, how about a thumbs up? So in this video, I will walk you through the process of identifying keywords and use AI tools to do keyword clustering. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that brings you easy to use SEO and AI tools. And this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, many people get confused with grouping keywords by category, or some will call it topic clustering, and keyword clustering. They are two different things, so we have to address this before moving forward. For a new site to have a good site structure, we always recommend starting with the silo structure. For example, if we have this list of keywords and plan to organize our blog into categories, a silo structure helps ensure strong topical relevance by grouping keywords into these categories. For instance, how to maintain a BBQ smoker has an informational intent, meaning people are searching for information. This can be categorized under the BBQ equipment section. Similarly, best wood for smoking meat fits under the BBQ techniques category. And these other keywords can be grouped under the respective category. This is called topic clustering. It focuses on grouping related content based on broader categories. It is not the same as keyword clustering, which groups keywords that share the same meaning and search intent for a single piece of content. However, both topic clustering and keyword clustering are essential steps in building a strong silo structure. If you haven't watched our video on creating a silo structure right here, we highly recommend watching it because it can help reinforce the knowledge you will get in this video. You can find the link in the description as well. And if you already know what a silo structure is, great, let's move on. For those of you who are not familiar with the concept of keyword clustering, here are some reasons why it is important. With keyword clustering, it improves your overall SEO performance by targeting multiple related keywords within a single piece of content. You increase your chances of ranking for a broad range of search queries. Your one piece of content can attract traffic from various angles, not just one keyword. Secondly, a well-clustered piece of content often results in a well-rounded article that covers many different parts of the same topic. And since users can get all the answers in the same piece of content, it keeps users engaged longer. Thirdly, keyword clustering helps you avoid keyword cannibalization and allows you to be more efficient. Instead of maintaining several pages that could easily overlap, you can focus all attention on creating one high-quality article that addresses everything your audience is looking for. By the way, search engine favors more in-depth and comprehensive pages than superficial ones. And now that we know why keyword clustering is important, let's go through an example. There are many ways to identify keywords relevant to your blog or website, like using organic Google tools, such as Google Auto Suggest, where you will add a seed keyword and go through the alphabet list for keyword suggestions. Then the People Also Ask section, the Related Searches section, the Google Site Search command, where you will add your competitor's domain with the site colon, and it would review keywords your competitors are ranking for. You can also use your competitor's sitemap to find relevant keywords. There are also tools like Google Keyword Planner, RankBot, Answers.com, Answer the Public, WordStream, and many more. I know this might be overwhelming, so if you want to learn how to find highly relevant keywords step by step, we have a video right here that walks you through the process. The link is in the description. But let me just show you one example here. Let's use ChatGPT since it is widely available and free. You can write a prompt, let's say, generate a list of high volume, long tail keywords for the BBQ niche. You can substitute the BBQ to whatever niche your blog is in, hit enter or return, and a list of long tail keywords will be generated. You can of course ask it to generate more, but this is just for an example. Now with this list, you want to find the relevant search volume. Let's select this whole list of keywords, copy it, go to your Google Keyword Planner, use the Get Search Volume and Forecast tool, paste the keywords here, and hit Get Started. In just a couple of seconds, you will have the search volume data for your keywords. From here, you can sort the keywords with search volume, because there is no point in targeting keywords with no search volume. Then I recommend that you download the keyword data into CSV or Google Sheets. Use the plan historical metrics and not the plan forecast. And once you have the Google Sheets downloaded, when you find more keywords, you can add to the list. That's how you can easily find keywords related to your niche for free. And to know which keywords to target first for new blogs, watch the keyword research video I've talked about earlier. But keyword clustering is all about planning, so we can move on to the next step. Once you have generated a long list of keywords and you have confirmed that there is search volume for the keywords, it is time to group them into their blog categories. Let's say that I have this list of keywords, which was verified to have search volume with the Google Keyword Planner. I will select all the keywords and copy it. Then I could visit a tool like RankBot. It is a feature of RankMath and it is native to WordPress. Under RankMath SEO, visit the Content AI module and you will find the tool under the chat feature. You can write a command such as cluster the following list of keywords into groups based on their topic. Each group should contain keywords that are closely related to each other. And here's the list of keywords. And I'll paste in the keywords and hit send. And in just a couple of seconds, we have grouped the list of keywords into the barbecue chicken on gas grill category, the grilling techniques and tips category, barbecue sauce, smoking meat, and grilling other foods. Of course, you could use ChatGPT or Claude to do the same thing, but RankBot is geared towards performing SEO tasks, so you may get better results with it. Anyway, the next step is to do keyword clustering. Once you have done topic clustering, you can look into the keywords of each category to find keyword clusters. So let's say that I want to group this list of keywords in the BBQ chicken on gas grill category into the respective keyword clusters. I could add a follow-up command such as further cluster the list of keywords in the BBQ chicken on gas grill category into groups based on exact keyword variations and synonyms. Each group should contain keywords that are semantically similar or have slight variations or targeting the same search intent. For each cluster, choose a primary keyword that best represents the group and list the related variations. Each cluster should be as specific as possible. Use the following format. Hold Shift and Enter to go to the next line. You'll add the cluster, then the primary keyword, then go to the next line, keywords, and then we want to list all the keywords in the cluster. This is the format that we want. Hit Send, and here we go. These keywords are grouped together based on the same search intent. And now you can write one comprehensive article and rank for all these keywords. In this case, for this keyword cluster, I would target the keyword how to BBQ chicken on a gas grill, and the article should rank for all these keywords. Of course, don't stop here. Do keyword clustering for the remaining categories as well. Don't be surprised if the AI tool makes mistakes. No AI tool is perfect, at least for now, but they're getting done close. If they make mistakes, correct them. And remember, you are not just limited to RankBot. You can use other tools like ChatGPT or Claude to perform the same task. And if you have a bigger budget, then invest in one of the SEO tools like Ahrefs or SEMrush, and it can make it even easier for you to find topic and keyword clusters. So let's recap. The first step to everything is to identify keywords. This is a step where you want to generate as many keywords as possible without worrying about search volume. Then, once you have a long list of keywords, put them into Google Keyword Planner to get the search volume data. Then, selecting only the keywords with search volume, you want to group the keywords into different block categories. We recommend that you watch the silo structure video to understand more about it. Following that, you want to do keyword clustering on the list of keywords in each category. Now, what I've shared in this video stops at this point, but what's next? You have to validate the keyword difficulty of each keyword to determine which keyword to work on first. Especially for new sites, you do not want to target keywords that are highly competitive, otherwise your blog will hardly grow. For this step, we recommend watching the keyword research video to understand the process of validating the keyword difficulty. Then, once you have picked the right keyword, you want to start writing the content around the keyword clusters. For this step, I recommend watching this video on creating high-quality long-form articles with AI to write the first draft for you. You should always include your knowledge, experience, and expertise in your content. And finally, every 12 months since your last publication, you should revisit your page and update the content. And in the meantime, you want to optimize the content for keywords that it is already ranking for. Go to your Google Search Console, visit the Performance tab, then select Pages, assuming that this is the page you are updating. You want to click on it, then visit the Queries, and these are all the keywords your page is ranking for. Try to understand the search intent for each of these keywords. These are what we call genuine keyword clusters, because it is tested and proven that they belong to the same group. So you want to optimize your content for them. And if you find a keyword that has a different search intent, for example this, because this is one product versus the other, while the other require a list of page builders, then you will want to consider writing another piece of content targeting this keyword. You can also use RankMath's analytics module to achieve the same thing. Hover over RankMath SEO and visit the analytics module. Click on the SEO performance tab, scroll below and you will see all your pages. Click on one of them, and here are all the keywords your article is ranking for. And from here, you can optimize your content for these keywords. All right, that's the entire process of using keyword clusters to build a good site structure. If you find this video helpful, how about helping us out by smashing that thumbs up button? If you haven't subscribed to our channel, do so because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.